Number 14, Scarborough man dies at Grotto. Rahul Makhija, 23 years old, visited the Bruce Peninsula National Park with a couple of his friends. While there, he went diving off the cliff with his friends. Unfortunately for him, the water was very cold that day, causing him to involuntarily gasp when he entered the water. This filled his lungs with water, making it difficult for him to escape the water. Some witnesses saw him in distress and pulled him out of the water. However, unfortunately for him, their rescue efforts were for naught. Rahul Makhija was pronounced dead by drowning. Number 13. Man dies after hitting boat during cliff diving accident. This incident happened on 8th of June 2021 at the famed Raouche Rocks in Beirut, Lebanon. The man tragically lost his life after jumping off a 118-foot cliff. Due to the angle of the cliff, he couldn't really see directly beneath him. Bystanders were screaming at him not to jump, but, ignoring their warnings, he jumped anyway, only to crash into a boat on the way down. Although Fahd was taken to a hospital for treatment, it wasn't enough to save his life. Number 12. Man gets paralyzed while diving in Vancouver River. Cameron Thompson went swimming with friends in the Vancouver Island River. He decided to dive headfirst into a part of the river that was familiar to him. Unfortunately for him, the reflection of light on the river surface was playing tricks on him, causing him to misjudge the jump. When he dived, his head hit something hard, causing his neck to break into two points, paralyzing him immediately. Lucky for him, his friends, who had been trained in CPR and rescue actions, got him out of the water immediately. Through their actions, his life was saved. Number 11. Man dies after jumping from 75-foot cliff into Lake Powell. An 18-year-old identified as Apollo Telashoma jumped off the 75-foot cliff of Lake Powell, Arizona. Per the park rules, jumping from heights over 15 feet is prohibited. However, Telashoma didn't allow that to stop him. Unfortunately, he did not survive the fall, and his body was found floating unconscious in the water. Witnesses who spotted the body wasted little time in contacting the authorities, but by the time the authorities arrived at the scene, it was too little too late. Talashoma's body was transported to the Coconino County Medical Examiner's Office in Flagstaff, Arizona. Number 10. Two Americans die while scaling cliffs in Spain. Two Americans died in Mallorca while undergoing an exercise known as deep water soloing, which is a form of cliff climbing without ropes that relies solely on the presence of water at the base of a climb to protect against injury from falls. The pair, aged 35 and 25, were found floating in the water. There were no witnesses to their deaths. Upon investigation, it so happened that a rock slide happened during their climb, causing them to crash dangerously into the water. Their bodies were retrieved with the aid of a lifeboat, helicopter, and two jet skis. Number 9. Man narrowly avoids death in cliff diving accident in Wales. On July 9, 2018, mountain rescue expert Mark Humphreys was near the rocky cliffs of the village of Llanberis in northwest Wales. He spotted two friends about to cliff dive and decided to record them. The first of the two friends managed to complete his dive with little problems. While his friend was preparing at the edge of the cliff, a large piece of rock got dislodged and tumbled into the water. It was just a few feet away from the man in the water and would have crushed him totally if he had been a little closer. Number 8. Young woman survives terrifying cliff diving accident. A young woman named Jamie Brodsky took a trip alone to Italy to enjoy the summer of 2018. While there, she decided to partake in cliff diving with some other strangers she met on location. A few of those strangers jumped before Jamie and successfully made the jump. However, when it came to Jamie's turn, she tensed up and her jump was far smaller than it should have been. She tumbled down the rocks on the cliff and into the water. She had to get flown back to Boston in a stretcher and had multiple surgeries to save her foot, which became infected. Today, she's perfectly fine and continues to make light of the event on social media. Number 7. Temecula man dies at Copper Canyon. 19-year-old Kason Ryan Adams of Temecula, California, went cliff diving in Lake Havasu City. There, he jumped off the Copper Canyon large rock formation. Witnesses were expecting him to resurface, but he never did. His body was eventually discovered, and paramedics on site tried to revive him. However, despite their best efforts, he ended up succumbing to his wounds. Number 6. Man dies at Black Hole Pond. Eben Bartholomew went camping with a couple of his friends on September 1st, 2021. He left his wallet, keys, cell phone, and SUV at the campsite, going to wander on his own. After a while, he didn't return, causing his friends to alert authorities. The authorities then initiated a search of the 8,533-acre wildlife area on foot. Finally, they found his body with the aid of a submersible drone. Eben Bartholomew died after cliff diving into the Black Hole Lake, getting wounded and drowning. His body was removed and sent for formal identification and notification of his next of kin. Number 5. Cliff diver drowns in Ozark, Missouri. 41-year-old Thomas Painter died after he jumped from a 125-foot cliff near the Lake of the Ozarks, Missouri. The incident happened on September 7, 2021. He did not die immediately on impact. Instead, after he failed to resurface, he succumbed to his injuries and ended up drowning. His death marked the 11th drowning in the vicinity. Number 4. British man dies in cliff diving accident in Portugal. As soon as travel restrictions were lifted, Andy Kerr, a British man, flew out to Portugal with his model girlfriend, Carolina Markevica, who was from Latvia. On May 28, 2021, the two of them decided to go cliff diving in the European country. Andy Kerr did not survive the adventure. Details of his death have been kept under wraps. However, in the time since then, an outpouring of donations has flowed from his loved ones and relatives to help return his body to his native Scotland. Number 3. Man dies after jumping off a cliff at Long Lake. On June 29, 2021, a young man in Spokane County, Washington State, lost his life after a freak cliff diving accident. His death was witnessed by a number of witnesses at the scene. One of them is a distraught woman known as Nicole. The incident, she says, happened at The Cove, Fisk State Park. She says that the man ascended to a higher height on the cliff than anyone else before jumping down. Although some of his friends were telling him not to jump, he still went ahead with it. He had even more momentum than usual since he made a running jump in order to clear two large rocks at the bottom of the cliff. Unfortunately, he failed. Number 2. Indian student dies in Maktaqua cliff diving accident. Originally from India, 22-year-old Arnyam Bora was a student, bodybuilder, and martial artist in St. Thomas University, New Brunswick, Canada. He had been studying political science and international relations. On September 26, 2020, he told his girlfriend, Millie Squires, that he was going cliff diving at the Head Pond, about 12 miles west of Fredericton, with a friend. Millie first noticed something was wrong when Ari didn't text her that night. She contacted his friend, who informed her of the cliff diving accident. His body was retrieved from the head pond by RCMP divers the following afternoon. Since he was pretty well known on his small university campus, the event of his death sent ripples of devastation far and wide. Number 1. Twin Lakes cliff jumping accident. On Monday, July 19, 2021, a 28-year-old man whose name has been withheld decided to go cliff jumping with a couple of his friends at Twin Lakes, also known as Bottomless Lakes, behind Mount Swansea in the British Columbia province of Canada. After jumping off the cliff, several moments passed, after which the man did not resurface. In a panic, his friends rushed to the area to check it out, but they didn't find his body, no matter how hard they looked. Soon, the Columbia Valley RCMP and Columbia Valley Search and Rescue were on the scene, helping with the search. It wasn't until the next day that his body was discovered. By then, it was too late. Did you ever cliff dive? Let us know more about your experience in the comment section below.